How to build massive biceps. First, let's talk about the anatomy of the biceps, and we'll break down a scientific way how to build massive biceps, training techniques, sets, reps, all that great stuff. First, let's talk about biceps brachii. So on the biceps brachii has two heads, a long and a short, running from shoulder to the elbow. It's responsible for elbow flexion, which is the curling motion, right? And forearm supination, twisting palm upward, like holding a can of soup, so you're, or a bowl of soup. You're holding a soup, so your palm is upward. The brachialis is tucked underneath and adds thickness by pushing the bicep up. The brachioradialis is a forearm muscle assisting in curling, especially with neutral grip. So the biceps work more when the hand is supinated or with the palm facing up while you're doing elbow flexions. And the brachioradialis gets more targeted when it's in neutral position with the palms facing inward, or like a hammer curl grip on that. So you're going to get more of that on the neutral grip. The muscles work together, and research shows targeting them with varied grips and angles maximizes hypertrophy. Let's explain the best ways to get them to grow. So obviously isolation has been something where people want to isolate that muscle and try to get it to grow. Research has shown that compound exercises will help it grow more. So obviously there's the barbell curl, the dumbbell curl. It's kind of the best bang for your buck. The barbell curl is a bicep staple. The straight bar row allows heavy loading, driving tension. Remember, EMG and all those things aren't as accurate as we'd like them to be. People with squeezing their muscles makes it activated and focus on it. So again, you want a variety of these exercises. Dumbbell hammer curls. Hammer curls shift focus to the brachialis and brachioradialis. 2017 Journal of Electromagnetic Kinesiology study, Olivier et al. Measured 15 subjects and found 75% of brachialis activation with the neutral grip compared to 60% for standard curls. This adds arm thickness and unilateral loading, correct imbalances. It's a good thing. Chin-ups or a lat pull-down is a phenomenal exercise when done when it's focused on your bicep. You don't pull it down like a lat exercise, but you do it to focus really on the biceps. This is one reason why your gymnasts have such massive biceps, considering they're doing so much on the rings and so forth. Chin-ups with a supinated grip and compound is a great. In 2019, Medicine Science, a sports and exercise study by Udis et al. Tested 14 lifters and showed bicep activation of 80 to 85% MVC rivaling curls while hitting lats and traps. So granted, we can talk about exercises all day long. There's tons of bicep exercises out there. Bicep exercises in general aren't going to help you grow mass. It's going to be more related on, you know, are you doing explosive training? Are you doing force negative training? How's your volume? How's your sets and reps? Are you going to failure? You know, and as the total volume over it. So typically on average, 8 to 12 reps will maximize her hypertrophy with the proper time under tension, with 60 to a 2 minute rest periods in between for that muscle group. And then obviously 8 to 10 to 12 reps, depending on multiple factors. Obviously, if you're a lifter who's not under PEDs, you're going to need, you can't handle as much volume versus somebody who's on PEDs who recovers a lot more, can obviously hit it more frequently and hit it more often. This is going to be determined on your genetics and how you build muscles and all that. You might need longer rest periods. You might be able to do higher volumes, might need more endurance. You should not only focus on 8 to 12 reps. You should still do strength reps with 1 to 6 reps, also 15 plus reps. You should experiment with all different, and your body needs variety to continue to stimulate that muscle to grow. Exercises aren't the end all be all. It's again more based off of the training you're doing. Are you doing German volume? Are you doing explosive type exercises? Are you doing force negatives or increase negatives, drop sets, all stuff? So are you adding variety of stimulus to really tear down those muscle fibers to get those biceps to grow? Force negatives is a great thing to really tear apart that muscle and really stimulate it. But again, if you're a beginner, start with the basics, 8 to 12 reps, hit it, you know, 2-3 times a week. It is a bicep. It can be hit more often because it will recover quickly, more quickly based off of it being a smaller muscle. And it's harder to fatigue it. If you really tear it to shreds, obviously longer time periods will need for recovery. If you have more type fast twitch muscle fibers, you'll need longer recovery, shorter volume. If you are slow twitch fibers, it means you don't grow as much mass or muscle and so forth. You'll probably need to hit it more frequently and put more volume in it. And all those things will inherently help your biceps grow more massively. But again, you got to think about, it's more about the training that you're doing. Most people fall into the prey of, they get stuck doing the same thing over and over, and then they expect a different result. You have to hit that muscle. Isometrics, negatives, drop sets, different stimulus to really stimulate those muscles to grow, compound exercises, then breaking them down. And then sometimes you might be hitting it too much. Overtraining is a big thing. Don't work out your muscle so much that it doesn't have time for recovery. Obviously, you need really quality sleep. You need to eat really well to help you put on the muscles, proper nutrition, all that great stuff. So a really basic exercise routine is just like, you know, 8 to 10 sets to possibly 12 sets of 8 to 12 rep range with, you know, barbell curls, a lat pull down with a bicep emphasis, or, you know, a pull up or a chin up with more bicep focused on that, lowering slowly, force negatives, weighted reps, and things like that. You can do explosive training to kind of get you past sticking points to really get your muscles to be stimulated to help them grow more frequently. You can hit the muscle 2 to 3 times a week, depending on fatigue level, muscle type, and so forth. And those are the ways to get your muscles to grow massively, or your biceps more specifically. So train hard, train smart, train with variation, get different training stimulus. But again, you don't want to change it so frequently. Stimulus, stick with something for 4 to 8 weeks before you change it. If you're a slow gainer, you might want to stick with it longer. If you're very, we'd call a cat, like they pick up movements really fast, they're very high functional, very high athlete, high tune, they'll pick up movements, they pick up exercise, they adapt really quickly. You might need to change a stimulus on the 4 weeks things versus waiting for 8 to 12 weeks on changing the stimulus. But do different mesocycles, macrocycles to constantly add more stimulus to get those muscles to grow. And, you know, bicep curls, hammer curls, Scott curls, negative curls, using equipment, forcing negatives, strict form, all the things work well. But start as a beginner with the basics and work your way up to being a more advanced lifter. What I see most of the time is people just do the basics and they stay with that forever. They don't add force negatives. They don't add isolations. They don't add isometrics. They don't add German volume. They don't add drop sets. They don't do anything of variety. So therefore, they're stuck with the same biceps or the size that they can't get past. So if you really want to stimulate growth, you got to just break that muscle down and really provide that volume sets and reps and stimulus to get it to grow. That's really the secret. And obviously resting, nutrition, all those other factors do matter to get those biceps to grow as massively as possible. Hopefully this was helpful. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below. Let's keep focusing on your goals to getting the best results in the gym as possible. Here's to your success. Take care.